O transporte de alta tecnologia domina Epcot. O monotrilho, uma pista de testes, até uma viagem ao espaço sideral. Mas uma das mais novas atrações utiliza uma tecnologia de última geração para dar aos visitantes a sensação de pairar no ar.
A sensation that is almost like free flight. It is such a unique experience.
We were able to tell a pretty compelling flight story with fairly high technology and some illusions that are quite unique.
Presos nos bancos, os visitantes são levantados a 12 metros de altura e imersos em um filme que simula um voo sobre a Califórnia. Eles sentem a brisa, cheiram os odores e pairam com o vento. É uma combinação de efeitos visuais e tecnologia de movimento. Mas o projeto quase não saiu da prancheta. Os projetistas sabiam que eram capazes de produzir um grande filme. Afinal, trabalhavam com imagens há décadas. O maior desafio era criar o movimento.
One idea was, if you think of going to your dry cleaners and when your clothes go by in the moving rack, we were going to do something like that, where you'd be in a flying harness and sort of suspended and moving along.
Most of the early concepts involved multiple floors of a building. Maybe we'd have three floors. And we would take people up there, put them in this ride vehicle, and somehow move them horizontally out above the screen. The more we studied that, it sort of became very cumbersome because you have to move people up and down stairs or elevators or escalators all day long. And frankly, it was about to sink the attraction. We decided, you know, it's just not going to pencil out.
Então, no fim de semana de Ação de Graças, Mark Sumner teve uma ideia. Para testá-la, ele utilizou um brinquedo de infância.
It was an old erector set. And I pulled it down out of the attic and blew off the dust and started going through the pieces. And I thought, you know, there's probably enough pieces here to make a little representation of what I want to demonstrate. So I started putting it together with some string and some wire ties and some hot glue. Over a period of about 3 hours in my garage, I put a little erector set model together.
Na segunda-feira, ele apresentou a ideia à equipe de planejamento.
So I put this model on the table. I said, how about if we load people here in three rows, and then we'll have an electric motor that can then move them up into the screen area. And while they're up there, since we already have this motor, maybe we can move them around, maybe we can swing them back and forth a little bit. And when they're done, we can simply bring them back down to a normal theater environment and let them leave.
E foi exatamente isso que fizeram em uma escala muito maior.
It takes about 1 million pounds of steel just in the ride system to make it work. But it works just like this. I don't have to turn a crank on the big one. I don't think I could, but we have electric motors that can do that.
These are 1,000 horsepower electric motors and gears that produce a situation where we've got 50 people or so on one lift mechanism that are sitting out on the end of a big arm that's connected to a big device that moves in and out.
Todo o trabalho pesado de engenharia visa criar voo ultra leve.
We want them to have that feeling that they're really flying on a hang gliding experience, that they're not on a 30-ton monster that's moving them up into the air.
Para aumentar o realismo da atração, foram adicionados pequenos detalhes como vento e odores para combinar com o cenário do filme.
So what we ended up with was this aluminum wing. It's built much like an airplane wing that is raised when you set down, but then just before you lift off, it comes down. Built into that for each guest is a variable speed fan, and it's actually behind them and it's very quiet. And inside the wing, we've designed these air chambers that actually bring it around to the front and will blow wind in your face. We can vary the wind pressure to match the scene. When we decided to add the scents, to add a little extra, we found out that we could take our scent boxes. We have mechanisms that will inject scents, and we actually inject that into each of the fans. So it's not like it's overbearing, it just sort of is in the wind like it would be if you were actually hang gliding.
Atualmente, é uma das atrações mais populares de Epcot.
You can go to a movie, you can go on a ride. How often do you combine the two?
Todas as noites, 365 dias por ano, Walt Disney World explode com fogos de artifício. O parque é o maior consumidor mundial de fogos, consumindo cerca de 1 milhão de cartuchos por ano. Em Epcot, cada show de fogos noturnos consome 1.105 cartuchos individuais. Eles são lançados de 750 tubos de morteiros e 56 módulos de disparo, localizados em 34 pontos em torno da lagoa. Muitos deles são lançados de barcas flutuantes que são preparadas todas as manhãs em uma lagoa secundária. Mas o show vai muito além dos fogos. Música, lasers, jatos de fogo, fontes e um globo de 8 metros ajudam a criar uma exibição sem igual.
One of the most fascinating things for me about this show is the ability for everything to work together electronically and for the precision timing that you can achieve during the fireworks show.
Um conjunto de 26 computadores comanda o show. A precisão da coreografia é possível graças a interruptores eletrônicos de disparo que lançam os fogos e espoletas de tempo que os inflamam no ar. O parque também está utilizando uma nova técnica, ar comprimido.
Air launch replaces that black powder bag with compressed air, so it's actually like a giant pea shooter. And we shoot the shell up into the sky using compressed air. Because we are using compressed air, we can control the amount of pressure, and the amount of pressure determines how high the shell will go.
Assim que o cartucho está no ar, uma tecnologia ainda mais sofisticada entra em cena. Um chip eletrônico em cada cartucho controla a explosão com uma precisão de fração de segundo. Abaixo, uma barca lança chamas tão altas que os espectadores podem sentir o calor.
We have liquid propane that we store on board the Inferno barge. And again, that's a lot of firepower, so we had to figure out how to do that safely. The idea was to make it a pontoon-style barge and put the propane tanks down under the water, so there's no risk of them catching fire or getting overheated during the show.
A criação dos efeitos pirotécnicos envolveu muita experimentação.
We took an area in the back part of the property and we gathered a bunch of buckets and old tin cans and fire hoses and pipes and just started shooting streams of liquid propane into these different devices to generate different styles of splashes or tubes or any type of array of liquid that we could think about, and then lit them on fire and see what they looked like. We used to joke, it was like every 12-year-old boy's dream come true to go out in the backyard and play with fire and do things that you really shouldn't be doing.
A água contrapõe os fogos. Quatro barcas com fontes, equipadas com 160 bocais, lançam 60 mil litros de água por minuto na forma de colunas que dançam e saltam a até 12 metros de altura. Mas a principal atração do show é o equipamento mais complexo já construído pelos técnicos da Disney. O Earth Globe é a primeira tela de vídeo LED esférica no mundo. 15 mil LEDs individuais no globo reproduzem imagens de arte e da natureza sincronizadas com a música e a narração do show. A bordo da barca, há seis computadores que geram os sinais de vídeo, acionam 258 lâmpadas estroboscópicas e controlam todos os outros efeitos especiais do globo. O globo e a barca levaram um ano para serem construídos. Em seguida, a esfera de 175 toneladas precisou ser colocada sobre a barca.
The barge was actually set up about a big tractor trailer truck with 18 or 20 hydraulically controlled axles. Each one was independent. It took us about 2 days to move the barge from the north end of property to here. Then we had a 400-ton crane that set up on the other side of the lagoon over here. We picked the barge up and we set it down in the water. We set it up in a low part of the lagoon, so if for some reason the barge sank to the bottom, nobody would notice and we would have had time to recover. But luckily it floated, sat down in the water, everything was fine.
A barca fez sua estreia em 2000. Enquanto Epcot utiliza tecnologia e inovação para promover uma visão da harmonia mundial, os estúdios Disney MGM utilizam os mesmos recursos para criar atrações inovadoras.